One of the greatest honors that I had as Speaker of the House was to be with Nelson Mandela, President of South Africa. I know for some conservatives that may seem surprising, but let me explain briefly why I found Mandela so compelling when he came to receive the Congressional Medal of Freedom to be honored by the U.S. Congress and the President of the United States. This was a man who was faced with a regime, a dictatorship, if you will, that was determined to eliminate any opportunity for any African to have any political rights. Now, as somebody who was proud of the Americans who had stood up to the British, as somebody who was proud of the Americans who stood at Concord and Lexington and stopped the British Army, I had to believe in freedom, freedom for everyone. And Mandela stood up for freedom. In standing up for freedom, he was sentenced to 27 years in prison, 19 of them in a very small cell, about 8 foot by 6 foot. Imagine spending 27 years of your life in prison. But he didn't come out angry. He didn't come out bitter. He came out as a remarkably wise man who understood that his job was to bring together and reconcile his country, to bring together people of all backgrounds. And he had such deep compassion that he invited the prison guard who had watched over him to sit in the front row at his inauguration to say to the entire country, if I can reconcile with the guard who kept me locked up for 27 years, surely you can reconcile with your neighbors. He also had grown to recognize that many of the ideas of communism and socialism just didn't work. And he set out to reassure people that businesses could grow, that investment could come, that jobs were vital. The fact is that with all of its difficulties, South Africa is far better off today than many countries because Nelson Mandela set it on a path. Do they have a huge problem? Sure. But they'd have had much bigger problems without the wisdom of Nelson Mandela. This is a remarkable leader, someone worth studying, someone that it was an honor to have met and to have been able to, for a brief moment, realize what an extraordinary charismatic presence he was, and to realize what courage he had, what discipline, and what dignity. So all of us, I think, in his passing, can take a moment to recognize that this was a remarkable man who contributed to the freedom of the human race.